So here is our Earth, here is the North Pole, and I put the Z direction so that it's facing through the North. And basically, for this instance, I will also put my X direction like this, okay? Now imagine I'm here on the North Hemisphere and sending a projectile to the South. Now you'll recognize that the South direction is actually can be described by the theta or e theta unit vector in the spherical coordinate. So if this angle is theta, you'll remember, then we can write, for instance, the radial unit vector is like this, er, and e theta will look like this. And furthermore, see, like you have er, e theta, and then the e phi will be into the plane of this page. Okay, very well. So basically, when you are shooting south on northern hemisphere or in southern as well, south means that you are shooting in the e theta direction. And by the way, which direction E phi corresponds to? See, like it's like the eastern direction. So the east will correspond to E phi. Okay, very well. So this was the velocity of my projectile. So velocity then can be expressed as V times E theta. This is relative velocity for the frame of reference of the Earth, which is rotating. So we are shooting south or in the along the e theta direction. Okay, how about Earth's rotation? It's basically going to point up and it will have some omega e. So basically the Earth's rotation can be shown as its rotation rate along the k direction. So then we come to Coriolis formula. So F Coriolis is minus 2m omega cross product with the relative velocity, which is basically this quantity here, and this will be minus 2m omega Earth along the k direction cross product with v along the e theta. Okay, so basically let's look at how we can write e theta in terms of k and I here, because I choose my coordinate system so that the projectile motion initially is in the I k or xz plane. Like if you are not given a coordinate system, you can make your life easy by selecting it in a special way. Okay, so coordinate systems are here to help you, not to hinder you. And here basically then you can see that the e theta vector, so if we draw these vectors, so let me try to draw them. So here first of all I've got this e theta, which basically makes 90 degree with my k and I vectors. So in other words, so basically we can draw a little triangle here. So if I draw a triangle, and remember this is theta, this is 90 degrees, so it means this is theta and this is 90 degrees, this is theta. See, we can write e theta as, so k is along the sine, so sine theta k plus cos theta with a minus sign. Oh no, sorry, with a positive sign. Oh, the minus sign is in front of k, that's the thing. Plus cos theta I, okay? Good, so basically, and we know that k cross product k is zero, whereas k cross product with I is, so k i j is positive sign, so it will be j. And in this case, see, like the Both the J and the E phi are pointing to the same way, so it's the east. So let me just write this E phi to remind me that it's actually pointing to the east at the moment. So then the Coriolis force will be minus 2m omega E k cross product with V, so let me put it this way, V minus sine theta k plus cos theta I. So the Coriolis force will be minus 2m omega E V cos theta and k cross I is j, j. Okay. Or E phi. See, like the basically here is the interesting thing. So if we remember our Earth one more time. So in this coordinate system, basically theta is this. So theta changes from 0 to pi, 0 to 180 degrees. And here is when it is pi over 2. And if you are in the southern hemisphere, then your theta will look like this. So it means the following. So if you are in the north hemisphere, theta is between 0 to pi over 2, and cosine theta will be larger than 0, positive. In the southern hemisphere, theta is between pi over 2 to pi, and the sine or the cosine will be negative, so cosine theta is negative. And how can you remember these signs? Remember, like cosine theta is like the real part, and sine theta is the imaginary part. So cosine is basically, so this is like the angle theta, let's say. So this is like plus plus quadrant. And cosine, so this first one is for cosine and the second is for sine theta. Cosine is an even function, so it's like plus minus here. So since sine theta will change when theta becomes negative, and then minus plus minus minus. It's like the cosine theta, so the north is here and south is here. So check your complex numbers knowledge for this. Okay, so basically it means that F Coriolis will be towards west if you are in north, and F Coriolis will point to east when you are in south, and like when you are shooting south. Okay, very well. Because yeah, like just in case you get confused. So see, like south is like this, which is E theta, and if you are in the southern hemisphere, south is like this, E theta. Okay. But if you are shooting to the equator, for instance, in both cases, then they will actually have the same deflection sense, deflection direction. Okay. So I'd like to point out one more thing about the formula that we have derived in this non-inertial frame of reference and connected to the rigid body dynamics. So let's say we have a coordinate system y and capital X, and O is the fixed point. And let's say we have some rigid body here. Let's say we are using somewhere on the rigid body as our little x prime, y prime, or x little x and y if you wish. And then there is another point, let's say point A here. And I mean, it can be like a fixed on the rigid body. In this case, V relative and A relative will be zero. But if there is, for instance, another mechanism by which A can move around, like let's say A is on this additional mechanism, so it can move in this way with respect to point B. So then this is, let's say, R. Say this is RB. Now basically I like to write down the acceleration of point A, and it has many parts. So first of all, the parts that are coming from rotation that we have seen. So there are three parts. So there is the Coriolis term, which is 2 omega cross omega relative. There is the centrifugal term, omega cross omega cross r. Then there is, if there is angular acceleration of this rigid body on which B is connected to, then we have alpha cross r terms. And there is one more term. So as I said, like A may move along this guide, so it will be the term for the A relative, okay? And then there is one more term, and that term is basically our first example. It's like our first example in the non-inertial frame of reference, where like you have car itself is accelerating, so in this case point B might be accelerating, so we adapt this as well. And this is like in your book, if you want to check, it's I believe formula 514, and it's a very nice connection between this rigid body dynamics and non-inertial frame of references. Specifically, so for instance, like let's say if there's a case where A and B are on the same rigid body, then it means that V relative and A relative are all zero, because otherwise the rigid body will be deforming, which would violate the rigid body assumption. Then you can simply write A is AB plus the the centrifugal term plus the acceleration, the angular acceleration. And in this case, please notice that this is going to be always, be a normal force, and this will be a tangential force, okay? And in cases where this, there is a guide, so that there is V relative and A relative, then there is always a good selection of coordinate system. So maybe you can align this with X, right? So then V relative will always be along this I direction, and I relative will also be along this I direction, etc. In cases, again, when there is a guide, so there is V relative and A relative, then the vectorial form, or at least the direction of these vectors, will be known by the direction of the guide, and then you'll have simplification in the problems as well.